Good evening, my name is Jim Mathis. I'm a graduate of BCC in the class of 1983. Here tonight for our Bristol Paragon Awards. The Paragon Awards are created as part of the 50th anniversary celebration, and it became clear to the planning committee that the best and brightest result of the college's 50 years is found in the alumni who have gone on to do great things. We needed to capture the stories of those who have gone on before and to share those stories with current and future students to inspire them to make their own place in greatness. The Paragon Award and the Hall of Fame installation serves to recognize those who make the college proud. The Alumni Association asked the Committee of Alumni to create the criteria and reach out for nominations for the award. We were overwhelmed to receive more than 60 great nominations from all over the country. The committee had the challenge of narrowing down that strong pool to those we are recognizing tonight. I would like to recognize those who helped to plan and execute this very important event, and would the committee please stand and receive a round of applause. And now we begin. The first award this evening is the Alumna of the Year Award, and the recipient is Elaine Emon, class of 1980. Elaine? Elaine Emon was the class valedictorian at BCC. She graduated in 1980 with a 4.0 grade point average and received an associate degree in science and child care. She later attended SMU, now UMass Dartmouth, and graduated in 1988 with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Humanities and Social Sciences with a minor in Elementary Education. Elaine is the Group Daycare Administrator, Owner and Director of Almost Home Nursery and Daycare, LLC. She is approaching her 10-year anniversary of being in business. In 2016, she was the Member of the Year of the New England Vikings Motorcycle Club. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And is a member of the National Association of Professional Women. She volunteers for several local nonprofits, as well as being an American Cancer Society Relay for Life team member for many years. She's a Hearts of Hope volunteer for the past 2 years and a Soldier's Angel for the past 8 years. Elaine continues to be involved in her alma mater. For several years now, she has invited BCC early childhood education students to serve as interns at her daycare center. The next award is for the Distinguished African American Alumnus of the Year. And he's not able to join us tonight, but I still want to share his story with you. The recipient is Christopher Oyanuga, class of 2012. Christopher attended BCC in 2010 and 2012. After BCC, attended Wentworth Institute of Technology in the University of Maryland. He has a Bachelor of Science degree in Civil Engineering and a Master of Engineering degree in Structural Engineering and Project Management. He's a Construction Task Supervisor at Bechtel. Previously, he was a structural engineer in the Nuclear, Security, and Environmental Global Business Unit and received the 5 Leader Plus Awards. Christopher is a member of several organizations. Some of his involvement includes leading several community service events. He planned 2 Boston Project Mission Hill Road races, was in the Wentworth Ski and Snowboard Club, was a bridge mentor for first and second year students, and a member of the Project Management Institute. Christopher stated, and I quote, "I know that Bristol Community College helped shape me into the man I am today, and I'll never forget where I came from. I've been blessed with opportunity after opportunity, and none of that would have been possible without starting my journey at BCC. I have been transformed through higher education, and it just keeps getting better." Unfortunately, he was not able to be here tonight, but how about a nice round of applause for Christopher? The next award is the Maury Kuzinets Volunteer of the Year Award, and the recipient is Erwin Apaza, class of 2010. Erwin Apaza is a 2010 graduate of BCC. And while here, he was a BCC student ambassador, master tutor at the Tutoring and Academic Support Center, member of the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, and tutor at Quest Writing Lab. After BCC, he received his baccalaureate degree at the University of Massachusetts Amherst and studied pathophysiology and immunology graduate studies at Harvard University Extension School. He's currently the manager at Thread Screen Printing and Alterations. He served as head deacon from 2013 to 2015 and an ordained elder youth leader from 2009 to 2013 at the Fall River Hispanic Seventh-day Adventist Church. He is a volunteer cook at the Amherst Survival Center, president of the University of Massachusetts Pre-Dental Society, and volunteer chair of the Food Bank of Western Massachusetts. Erwin stated that his main motivation this time around is not fame, degrees, title, or money. He is deeply moved by generosity, humility, kindness, and integrity. Looking at his past, he is able to make wiser decisions. As a husband and father of two children, he's motivated to establish a legacy that he not only can leave for his children, but for the community as a whole. This self-motivation has allowed Erwin to live by his slogan, never give up. Failure is surely not final, and he wants to encourage the world to pursue their passion. I am pleased to announce that presenting the award to Erwin Apaza, along with President Sprague, is Tara Kuzinets, the granddaughter of Maury Kuzinets. Next up are the Outstanding Service Awards. These awards are given annually to alumni from Bristol Community College who are making significant achievements and contributions to their profession or community and or share a commitment to the service of others in the community. This year, the Outstanding Service Awards are presented to 10 deserving candidates. As we mentioned earlier, we have more than 35,000 alumni that have gone on to accomplish excellent things. Choosing just 10 is no easy task. Our first recipient tonight is Ann Borges, class of 1988. Now everybody's paying attention, Ann. Ann attended BCC in 1988. She later attended the University of Massachusetts at Dartmouth, where she received a Bachelor of Science in Accounting. Ann is a certified public accountant and owner of Ann M. Borges, LLC. Ann is the first treasurer of the Holy Ghost Society at Immaculate Conception Church, and she's also very involved with St. Anthony of Padua Parish, where she is a member of the Parish Council Committee and Parish Finance Committee. Ann was taught from a very young age that hard work and patience always persevere through, although it might not seem that way at times. She stated, "In my parents' home, you always just did what you had to do. This has been my approach in life. In particular, I learned how we choose to earn a living doesn't define who we are. Rather, it is how we use our gifts and how we treat others that define us." Ann? Congratulations. Next, please welcome Christopher Carrero, class of 2010. Christopher graduated from BCC in 2010. While at BCC, Chris received the Fall River Herald News Best and Brightest Award and the All Massachusetts Academic Team Award. Christopher also received a BCC Foundation Scholarship every semester. After BCC, Chris attended the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth Charlton College of Business and Roger Williams University School of Law. He is currently a sole practitioner attorney at Carrero Law Office and has been a Swansea volunteer firefighter for 9 years. Chris was elected to the Swansea School Committee when he was a student at BCC in 2010, where he's had the pleasure of serving as both chairman and vice chairman. And he was recently elected to the Select Board in Swansea this past April at the age of 26. Our next recipient, John Jack DeLuz, also cannot be with us tonight. He's in the class of 1968. Jack DeLuz is a 1968 graduate of BCC. After BCC, Jack attended SMTI, Charter Oak State College, and Webster University. He is a retired commander for the Aurora, Colorado Police Department, where he achieved executive status. Jack also received the Medal of Honor, the department's highest award for demonstrated valor in the line of duty, as well as the life-saving award for successfully performing CPR on a drowned infant, and he also was the Officer of the Year. In May 2007, he organized the largest police-related community outreach project in the history of the department, which brought more than 350 officers and citizens together over 4 days to explore the nature of the relationship between the department and the citizens served. And if that weren't impressive enough, he's also a graduate of the prestigious FBI National Academy in Quantico, Virginia. This is an executive-level leadership program that requires a three-month residence. And unfortunately, Jack's not able to be here, but how about a nice round of applause? Next, I ask you to please welcome Sari Fonseca, class of 1991. Sari is a 1991 graduate of BCC, where she was the recipient of the Clinical Lab Science SERPA Scholarship. After BCC, she attended Curry College and received a Bachelor of Science in Health Education. She also attended the University of Rhode Island and received a Master of Science in Clinical Lab Science. Sari is a clinical laboratory scientist and medical technologist and a clinical specialist in microbiology at Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital in Plymouth, Massachusetts. Next, I ask you to welcome Marcus Gesner, class of 1997. Marcus graduated from BCC with a degree in nursing. After BCC, Marcus attended North Adams State College. He is currently the Vice President of Post-Market Quality at Boston Scientific. He has received numerous quality achievement awards and was a graduate of an Executive Accelerated Leadership Program. He's a member of the American Society for Clinical Pathology. Marcus would like the opportunity to demonstrate and speak to BCC graduates, nursing students in particular, about the value of a degree, the quality of a BCC degree, and what can be achieved in your career post-graduation. He would love to share his journey to and through BCC and his post-graduation career, achieving a vice president position with a Fortune 500 company. Next, please welcome Philip Oliveira, class of 1983. Was a good year, Phil. Yeah. Philip Oliveira is a 1983 graduate of BCC. He received an associate's degree in electromechanical engineering. After BCC, he attended SMU, and in 1998, he received a bachelor's degree in business management from Lesley College. Philip is currently the global supply chain director of global procurement at EMC Corporation. In addition to Six Sigma Black Belt certification, he is a certified Shingo auditor and lean champion and facilitator. He has participated in EMC's executive training program at Babson College and EMC's Emerging Leader Program, as well as being trained in medical GMP's AAMI. He has received a continuous process improvement certificate from Worcester Polytech Institute and become a certified Zinger Miller course trainer. Philip says, BCC gave me my start. The folks at BCC made me feel like anything was possible, and they were right. Through hard work, devotion to family, community, and career, I have turned my BCC start into a productive and fruitful life experience. I now hold a position at Dell as Director of Global Procurement and have a staff of 35 team members at three locations, North Carolina, Massachusetts, and Ireland. I work with suppliers from China, Mexico, Thailand, Ireland, and many other countries and cultures. Philip. Congratulations. Next, please welcome Melissa Pacheco, class of 1994. Melissa graduated from BCC in 1994. After BCC, she attended the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth and received a Bachelor of Science degree in accounting in 1998, as well as her MBA in 2007. She is currently in the UMass Education Leadership Program, where she is working toward her PhD with an anticipated graduating date of 2020. She's currently the Assistant Dean of Graduate Programs for the Charlton College of Business at UMass Dartmouth. She's involved in many community organizations, which include the Fall River Chamber of Commerce, the New Bedford Area Chamber of Commerce, Westport Education Foundation, American Heart Association, Mended Little Hearts Boston, Boston's Children's Hospital, Third Baptist Church of Fall River, and Junior Achievement. Per Melissa, Bristol Community College provided me an educational foundation that allowed me to pursue my dreams and goals. When I graduated from high school in 1992, I had no idea what I wanted to do. My first inclination was to become a paralegal. However, my first year at BCC opened up new doors and inspired me to want to continue my education. After one semester at BCC, I realized there were no boundaries and my opportunities were endless. Our next recipient also could not be here this evening, David Ragsdale. David attended BCC from 1991 to 1993. After BCC, he attended Thames Valley University in London and Hofstra University in New York. He is the executive producer, director, and owner of Hot Buttered Content Incorporated. He's just not able to be with us tonight. David was the multi-award-winning content creator for many of the globe's biggest entertainment and consumer brands. He received a Telly Award, plus many other industry awards over the years. In the course of David's career, he has worked with clients such as Sony Pictures, Warner Brothers, Disney, TV Guide, Universal, The Rolling Stones, U2, Beyoncé, The Who, Aerosmith, AC/DC, Genesis, The Police, Tommy Hilfiger, Calvin Klein, Estee Lauder, J-Lo by Jennifer Lopez, Ann Taylor, Loft, Pepsi, and Intel. And it all started here at BCC. How about a nice round of applause for David Ragsdale? Next, please welcome a familiar face to many in Fall River, in particular, John Souza, class of 1977. I guess when I say familiar face, hopefully for a good reason. John is a 1977 graduate of BCC. While at BCC, he received the Charles Croshaw Memorial Award for academic excellence and leadership, and he graduated with highest honors. After BCC, John attended Bryant College, now Bryant University, where he received a Bachelor's of Science in Criminal Justice, grabbing magna cum laude. He also received his Juris Doctorate degree from the New England School of Law, now New England Law, in Boston, where he graduated summa cum laude. He is an adjunct instructor here at Bristol Community College and a retired police chief for the Fall River Police Department. John's many community organizations he's involved in consist of the following: Board of Directors for the Fall River Municipal Credit Union, member of the Massachusetts Police Association, member of the Massachusetts Chiefs of Police Association, member of the American, Massachusetts, and Rhode Island Bar Associations, admitted to the Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Federal Bar, member of the Fall River Chamber of Commerce, former member of the Prince Henry Society of Fall River. John says, and I quote, "I have taught various courses in the criminal justice curriculum for the past 6 years, and I feel that I bring a great deal of experience to each of my classes. Most importantly, I'm always sure to advise all of my students that I once sat where they now sit, and that Bristol Community College provided me with a very strong foundation to have a successful career, and that I'm here to help them build their own foundation." And finally, I want you to please welcome Martha Wiggins, class of 2009. Martha is a 2009 graduate of BCC. And while here, she received the John Carissimo Scholarship and graduated magna cum laude with an associate degree in Applied Science Culinary Arts. Martha is the executive chef at Sylvain Restaurant in New Orleans. Honors received include the following: the 2015 Times-Picayune Chef to Watch, one of Gambit's 2015 Emerging Chefs. Her holiday snacks graced the cover of Food and Wine in December of 2015. In 2016, she was included in Zagat's 30 Under 30 New Orleans. She says, "I'm forever grateful to BCC and especially to Chef John Carissimo for the invaluable education and the life lessons he and they have passed on to me." Folks, I think you'll agree that this is an incredible group. They represent BCC so well. We love the fact that BCC had a role in helping build their character and success. So how about one more round of applause for our outstanding service recipients. And we want to organize all of them up here for a photo opportunity as well. And now it's my privilege, probably for the last time, maybe I have one more shot, to introduce a man who I have just tremendous respect for in all that he has done here, and wish him well in his retirement, but really wish he stayed another 10 or 15 years. Please welcome our president, Jack Spraga.
Thank you, Jim. Well, let's hear it for Jim. What is an amazing MC. He's terrific. So what follows, an institution depends heavily on its alumni, and what follows is that Bristol Community College is an outstanding institution because we have such outstanding alums. These stories inspire and challenge us, and they make us proud to have had some part in their world-changing work and in their lives. We're very proud of that. So to celebrate the college's 50th anniversary, the college established a Hall of Fame last year, and this evening we are inducting three of our outstanding alumni in that Hall of Fame. Their stories will be on the wall in this room, as well as online, in an effort to inspire students and alumni over the years to come. To identify all the award winners this evening, the Alumni Association sent out a call for nominations. We received more than 60 nominations from faculty, staff, alumni, and community members. Every nomination represented a life well lived so far and life of honor and accomplishment. A volunteer committee read each nomination with great attention and identified the 13 people that we are honoring tonight. The Paragon Award is intended to recognize those who demonstrate excellence in their life's work, service to the college, and substantial community involvement. And it is my honor to introduce the 2017 Paragon Award winners.
I am a licensed architect in the state of Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Connecticut. I provide architectural design for primarily commercial buildings, but also for residential properties. The most affordable and only choice for me was coming to VCC. And I ended up getting 2 degrees, civil engineering and land surveying, and then worked for a few years before I went back to school. If I was perfect, I'd be much taller than this, that's for sure. But I just think a paragon, to try to relate to myself, I just do the best I can in my field, at home, in my community. I try to give back whenever I can. You have to give back because you didn't get where you are without some kind of help, so it's just meant to be that you have to help others. That's just the way it is. If I hadn't have come here, I would not have continued on at all. It gave me the start that I needed. All my courses transferred. I went to Rhode Island School of Design later. Everything transferred. There's nothing wrong with going to community college, getting your start, and then going on later if you want to.
Joanne Bentley, ladies and gentlemen. Joanne Bentley.
Thank you, everybody. Good evening, President Spraga, members of the Trustees, Foundation, family, friends, and other honored guests. It's my great honor to accept this Paragon Award, and I cannot tell you how humbled I am to have been chosen for this distinction. It has long been my pleasure to be involved with VCC, from my first step on campus here as a student in 1977, right through to tonight. I know that VCC was the main reason that I am where I am today. Had I not started here as a student, I would never have been able to go to college, as VCC was my only affordable choice. With my degrees from VCC, I was able to get a job, work for a few years, and then can return to college to complete a 5-year degree in architecture. VCC was what launched me into my career, and I believe that I've been able to help my community with my volunteer efforts. I believe that we all get where we are with the help of family and friends. So thank you, BCC, my BCC family, for helping me become the person I am today. Thank you very much.
It all started here at BCC, given the opportunity here to get my confidence. There was two amazing instructors. One was Ray Lovertu, who was the head of the criminal justice here when I first started, and an instructor, a former Newport police officer, Norman Mathers. They gave me that opportunity and vision of life as a police officer and that you can make a change in a positive way, and this is where it all started from. I feel very lucky and, you know, that I met these two instructors from the school. But that's what the school means. It provides that confidence to people that, you know, you can do what you want to do. You can reach for your dreams. And I'm a prime example. Even as chief of police, I constantly tried to give back. My concentration now is community policing. I became known nationally for community policing through the National Center for Community Policing and trying to give back to the community and inspiring young people. Education is the major component for success in this world. If I can inspire another student from high school about education and to let them know education is independence and you can make a difference and you can start right here, because I did.
Chief William Fitzgerald, please come up. William Fitzgerald.
This is probably the shortest speech I've ever made in my life. A lot of help from the college here. Good evening, everyone. I'm honored to be one of the recipients of the 2017 Paragon Award. I would like to thank the Bristol Community College Alumni Association for this recognition, as I am overwhelmed and humbled to be honored with this prestigious Paragon Award. I would like to thank retired Captain Alan Rolfe, who is an instructor here, who is a special friend and a former colleague of mine in law enforcement, who nominated me for the special award. There are so many people that have impacted my career, from high school graduation to entering BCC in 1976. I didn't really want to say 76, but. I was the first generation student, the first in my family to enter college. I also had a lot of uncertainty as I entered this new field of my dream of becoming a police officer. I knew that this is what I wanted to do because I wanted to make a positive difference in the community. There were two people that gave me the confidence and the exposure to the criminal justice field: Mr. Ray Laverto, the chairman of the criminal justice program, and instructor Norman Mathers. Their encouragement and motivation provided me the course to come to my life. They were inspirational, to say the least. In closing, I would like to say that educational environment at the BCC taught me to work hard, to stay committed, and the most importantly, to believe in yourself. I have stood by this philosophy throughout my career. Today, I am the chief of police at Winchester, Connecticut Police Department. This philosophy has taught me well. It has enabled me to climb to the pinnacle of my profession, but always to make a positive impact in the community. Community service is an honor and a privilege. It should never be taken lightly as we serve as partners within our community. To quote the author Salomon Ortiz, education is the success in life, and teachers make the lasting impact in the lives of their students. Thank you.
My first career was 22 years as a police officer for the city of New Bedford and a detective. I would say it was challenging, rewarding, and terrifying at times. My other career, that as an assistant clerk magistrate, was the one that I truly could make a difference in someone's life. The power to keep someone in jail or not in jail weighed on me at times, but I trust that I did my research in being able to come to the correct decision. Bristol Community College was the start of my educational career, coming from a family that could not afford to send me away to college. Carpooling with others created a bond with other students that I have until this day. In fact, I happily married one of them. The availability of such fine professors and the selection of courses proved for me to be a stepping stone in doing well and having the confidence to further my education at a four-year university. I grew intellectually, socially, and civically, and Bristol Community College gave me the opportunity to think and make the best possible decision as a young adult. A paragon is one of excellence, and to be named amongst the Bristol Community College alumni is truly a humbling and honorable experience. My particular quality in sticking with the definition would be one of compassion for others. I view my life here on earth, one to share with others whatever I can offer them, be it time, money, or advice in making theirs a better life. I'd want students to learn that not everyone is cut from the same cloth. What is easy for one might not be the same for another. They need to reach out to those who need it and embrace the qualities that were given to them to share with others. We are renters here, and we need to pay it forward for the other tenants.
Cynthia Rose, ladies and gentlemen. Cynthia, congratulations. So proud of you.
Good evening. Thank you all for attending this evening. My congratulations to all the Outstanding Service awardees and to the Paragon awardees. As you know, this is the second year that the Bristol Alumni for the Bristol Alumni Paragon Awards. I believe it is important to recognize the individuals that have come through these doors and continue to go out into their communities and make a difference. We certainly do not require all this attention, but it is nice to know our service to the community does not go unnoticed. All of us getting our start at BCC and continuing in our chosen careers put this college on the map for others to see just how great our educational experience has been. I'd like to thank the committee for choosing me and also thank Karen Giglio for nominating me. She could not be here tonight, but I wanted to acknowledge and thank her. Also, thank you, my family and my family, which is friends and family, who came to support me, as they always do. A very big thank you to my dear husband, Bruce, who is always there for me and so, so supportive of me without question. We actually were classmates in 1968 at BCC, and we did graduate together. Our paths in life have come full circle after all these years, so thank you. I also want to thank my BCC family. After serving on the Board of Trustees for 10 years, my time is coming to an end, but certainly not an end to all the relationships created within that time. My best wishes go out to Dr. Sprager as he retires in a few months and goes on to the next chapter in his life. I certainly wish him health and Godspeed as he embarks on his next journey. Also, he did receive a big award today at the State House from the governor, but it was at the State House for his 17 years in higher education. So please give him a round of applause. Thank you. We truly will miss him. I've enjoyed it so much. Now, where do I start about BCC? I truly believe it has been the catalyst of my success in both of my careers. My professors, as well as some administrators, always guided me in a direction that I did not think possible. As an 18-year-old student while here at the campus, I grew intellectually, socially, and civically. My eyes were open to events around me that were not fair and just, but learning what actions to take taught me the value of free speech. It allowed me to go into a career of public service and being able to not only help those that needed it,
but also those that were powerless to stand up for themselves. Most people have one career that they love, but I was fortunate to have two careers that I truly, truly loved. The decisions that I had to make always had an impact on someone's life, be it negative or positive, but I always tried to treat those as I would have liked to be treated. Weighing the consequences of actions and trying to make a difference in someone's life is truly a fine line that can impact the future of oneself forever. Common sense and compassion are two virtues that I feel I was blessed with throughout my life. As I learned, I taught. As I got, I gave, which was instilled in me as a young child. BCC taught me how to be independent in not only providing myself with the financial stability, but also preparing and becoming a responsible adult so that I was able to graduate and continue with my immediate plans. I consider my education here to be the backbone of my existence. There is a quote, I don't know who said it, but it is said, quote, "It is nice to be important, but important to be nice." I would hope that my dash, which is a poem by Linda Ellis referring to the dash on a tombstone and what you have done within that dash, I would hope that it would say she treated others with respect and all those lives she touched mattered to them and to herself. Bristol Community College will always be at the top of my list for shaping my life of what it is today, and I continue to sing the praises whenever I have the opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
We're going to have a group photo with our paragons up here in a moment. Wow, what some great stories. Congratulations to our paragons. And to hear those stories and how they all related the success that they've had in their lives, both professional and personal, back to the time that they spent here at BCC. It's a very powerful message, I think, for all of us to think about. As we've learned tonight, the road to success for many started right here at Bristol Community College. We are so lucky to have this college to serve students in our region. Please join me in one final round of applause to congratulate all of our inductees tonight. I want to thank you on behalf of President Spraga and the entire college for joining us in this new and well-deserved annual tradition. I would welcome all of you. It's still early. If you want to stick around, there's still lots of dessert. Please take your time and enjoy it. Congratulate those who've been recognized tonight. And when it's time to leave, please drive safely. Thank you.